the position of the neural tube and the heart development. First is this slide, this is amniotic cavity, this is yolk sac, this is ectoderm, this is endoderm, which is forming the yolk sac cavity, and this is allantois. This position is the position where the angiogenic clusters, cell clusters will be there forming the heart tube in future. This is your connecting stalk, okay? So this position is before your head folding. Now this head folding and tail folding is occurring. So what happens? There is a invagination of the gut tube and the neural tube, and the formation of the pericardial cavity and the loop of the heart tube. Now there is the two membranes are there only having ectoderm, endoderm, that is oropharyngeal membrane and cloacal membrane. Okay. So this folding is taking place because of the head fold and tail fold. This is because of the folding from the cranial end and from the caudal end. So this is the position of the head and tail folding. Now the more folding happens and there is more pushing up there. So what happens? The one with the angiogenic cluster, which is cranial to the heart tube, the neural tube, that will be pushed inside, and it is between the neural tube and the gut tube. So this is the position. So you see, this is your brain, this is your gut tube, in between is your heart tube, that is the development of the heart, because of more folding of the head fold. And similarly, there is more folding of the tail fold, which is giving rise to the formation of the allantois. Then we come to the more formation, more folding. So what is happening? You see this invagination of the cranial, this neurulation neural tube. This is your the foregut, this tube which is forming from the yolk sac. So this is your gut tube which is being formed, having this lung part over here from where the lungs will develop, that the respiratory diverticulum. This is your liver part from where the liver will be formed. So this portion is called the foregut. This is anterior intestinal portal, this is posterior intestinal portal. So from this to this, this is called the foregut. From anteposterior portal, this is called midgut, which has a communication with the yolk sac through a duct. This is called vital end duct, and this position takes place outside the baby within the extramembranic cilium. Okay. So this membrane is called oropharyngeal membrane. Here the membrane is called cloacal membrane, and this is your the allantois. So this is because of the more folding of the head tail folding. Now how what happens during the lateral folding. Now in a cross section, let us see, this is ectoderm, endoderm, this is intermediate mesoderm, here is a notochord formation. Because of the lateral folding, so this is a lateral folding for two sides, the intermediate mesoderm is pushing the endoderm to forming a tube. So there are two tubes to be formed, most due to neurulation neural tube, and there is a yolk sac tube, that is your endodermal, that is your gut tube. So there are two tubes over there. Anteriorly the tube is cranially, this is a neural tube, and then this is a gut tube. So this gut tube is formed because of the two lateral pushing. So what happened within the intermediate mesoderm? There is a formation of the cilium. This is called intraembranic cilium. So this intraembranic cilium on the two sides, they are being attached with each other by this mesentery. This is called dorsal mesentery. This is called ventral mesentery. Notochord being in the midline. So this is the notochord that is in the midline. And this is, you see, the formation of the gut tube, that is histological demarcation serosa, then the external mucosae, then the lamina propria, then the internal mucosae, and the epithelial lining lined by simple columnar epithelium. So this is your the gut tube histologically forming from the totally from the endoderm. So this position, you see, now what happens? The ventral mesentery will cross abolished. Only the dorsal mesentery forming, this is the peritoneal cavity. The gut tube is pushed from the back. This has got the visceral layer attached with the gut tube. It has got a parietal layer, and in between the parietal visceral layer, there lies the peritoneal cavity. So this is the position of the neural tube, position of the gut tube, formation of the gut tube, formation of the heart tube. There are three tubes. And with respect to the head fold and the lateral fold, this is the respective position of the neural tube, gut tube, and the heart tube. From the neural tube, the brain and spinal cord develops. From the gut tube, the foregut, midgut, hindgut develops. And from the heart tube, you know that the heart will develop. So this is your the position or respective position of the three tubes before the head fold, tail fold, and the after head fold, tail fold, and what happens during the lateral fold. That completes. is your the respective position of the three tubes in the body during informative years. Okay.